Executive Director of the Center for Democratic Development, CDD, Professor H.K. Prempeh, says vigilantism still persists in the country because a law alone will not be enough to resolve the issues. Professor Prempeh believes the solutions to the problem are more political than legal. He spoke in a yet-to-be-heard interview on Joy Prime's Current Affairs show, On the Record.
Action-related conflicts have really degenerated into, you know, just large-scale killings, you know, and conflict, sometimes close to civil conflict, civil war, in many other countries. And I think we should not take our luck for granted. Mm. You know, there is really nothing about us that makes us different from Cote d'Ivoire or Kenya, you know. And so I think it's something that we need to seriously manage. The underlying factors are there. But then on top of it are other things we ourselves, but the way we have managed or mismanaged our politics, have also introduced, which is this problem of vigilantes. Is the vigilantism problem a problem of inadequate law? I don't think so, right? So whatever it is, whatever violence, whatever threats of violence that are perpetrated by so-called vigilantes already offend existing law, right? So what is different is the political or partisan nature of the targeting. Mm. So I'm not opposed to saying that, for example, if you perpetrate violence on a person merely by virtue of their political identity or their party identity, we aggravate the offense and therefore you get a severe sanction. So the sanction side, we can change it. But otherwise, it's a criminal offense nonetheless.
But has the law itself changed anything?
Well, it does try to aggravate the sanction. But in terms of what it is that is driving this thing, they are political drivers. The drivers are political, they are not legal loopholes. And part of it is also, unfortunately, divided partisan trust, not just in the EC, but also in the security agencies who also play a major role in our elections.
Also in the interview, Professor Prempeh said the opposition NDC should be clear on what kind of jobs its proposed big push would create.
Definitely, we have huge job deficits in the economy, right? But what's a job? It's a job, unemployment. Or because each time you put a certain amount of money into something, you can create a job. But the job, after the project is over, the job vanishes, right? So what kind of jobs are they talking about? Are they talking about paid, sustainable employment? Or a job that is, you know, so if I hire you to build me a small gutter in the front of my house, to the extent that we have a market transaction, it's a job, I've created a job there. But if after the duration of that project, the gutter is built, and then there is, you know, that's the source of your income dries up, the problems will re-emerge. You throw money at it, it solves it for a time being, and then it re-emerges.